Yun di ba yung ano? Inmarsat 3 and 4?
Ah, yun ba yung...
Inmarsat 3F4 is a communications satellite operated by the British satellite operator Inmarsat. The company was originally founded in 1979 as the International Maritime Satellite Organization Inmarsat, a not-for-profit international organization, for the purpose of establishing a satellite communications network for the maritime community. Comsat Corporation also took the lead in the founding of Inmarsat. The Inmarsat then began trading in 1982. From the beginning, the acronym Inmarsat was used. The intent was to create a self-financing body which would improve safety of life at sea. When the organization was converted into a private company in 1999, the name was changed to International Mobile Satellite Organization, where it began to provide services to portable users and aircraft, but the acronym Inmarsat was kept. Inmarsat 3F4 was launched into a geosynchronous orbit on June 4, 1997. It is currently located at 54 west longitude, providing coverage to the Americans. The estimated velocity of the Inmarsat 3F4 is about 6,879 miles per hour. And the time it takes to complete one full orbit around a celestial body is almost 23 hours and 57 minutes. It has a height of 35,766 kilometers that should remain in a fixed location above one spot on Earth's surface. Inmarsat 3F4 was the fourth in a series of five third-generation satellites, developed by prime contractor Lockheed Martin and payload provider Matra Marconi Space. It was launched from the Kourou Space Center aboard an Ariane rocket that is expected to live for 13 years. It is currently in service over the Atlantic Ocean, providing data, communication and safety services in the L-band. In addition, the Inmarsat company also took care on the mystery behind the missing Malaysian Airlines flight MH370. The Inmarsat engineers concluded through a traditional mathematics-based process that the plane landed in a remote region of the southern Indian Ocean.
Salamat, ha? Yeah, 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 yeah. Ay! Teka, ano ba yung ano? Yung SSR 3?
Oh, star. Are, pupunta ka dun sa templo ng ano, templo ng Siguran Simbla. Tatawid ka ng pitong bundok at pitong dagat. Tapos makakausap mo dun ang pinakamatalino yung estudyante sa microwave. Ah.
Dito yung daan, ano?
Dito, 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 dito. Dito, dito, dito.
Ang pinakamatalinong estudyante na nag-aaral mo. Ano bang iyong sa Java?
Tatanong ko po sana kung ano ba yung EchoStar 3.
Alam mo bata, sa 10 taon kong tinake ang microwave, yung EchoStar 3 lang ang hindi ko nalaman. Pero, salamat makakasagot ng iyong katanungan bata. Alam mo ba yung mga Dragon Balls?
Oo!
Nagkaalat sila sa iba't ibang parte ng Alawakan. Kailangan mo silang hanapin. Doon makakausap mo ang mahiwagang dragon. Makakasagot ng iyong katanungan bata.
Ay sila!
Ano mo bata?
Doon yun, doon.
Doon yung Dragon Ball bata.
Kung hilingin ko na lang kaya na iuno niya kami lahat sa microwave. Shenron! Pwede bang iuno mo na lang kaming lahat sa microwave namin?
Isa kang mandurupang bata. Pasensya ka na. Hindi na yan sakot ng aking kapangyarihan. Iba na lang ang iyong hilingin. Pakisamahan akong pinggulay.
Pwede bang i-explain mo na lang sa akin kung ano yung EchoStar 3?
Masusunod.
The EchoStar 3 is the third satellite that was made to use by the EchoStar Corporation. The EchoStar 3 was authorized only to operate 11 transponders when it was launched in the geosynchronous orbit in October 5, 1997. It is currently located from 61.5 west longitude. The estimated velocity of the EchoStar 3 is about 6,879 miles per hour, and the time it takes to complete one full orbit around the Earth is almost 23 hours and 57 minutes. It has a height of 35,779 kilometers that should remain above the chosen location over the equatorial orbit. EchoStar 3 was launched from the Cape Canaveral aboard an Atlas IIAS rocket that is expected to live for 12 years in space. It is intended to operate in the central mountain region to eastern US to provide satellite communication and video delivery solutions in Ku-band. This satellite has experienced many failures causing limited use. Between the years of 1998 and the end of 2003, 7 pairs of transponders failed due to various reasons. During January 2004, another pair of transponders in EchoStar 3 failed again, resulting in loss of service. The EchoStar 3 may have failed, but the chairman of EchoStar, Charles Ergen, says that, in life and in business, there are people who complain and people who take risks. The rewards go to those who are willing to take a risk. EchoStar 3 terminated in August 2010 when it was replaced by EchoStar 15. EchoStar 3 now serves as an orbit spare. Today, EchoStar span more than 100 countries, and still continuing to expand into new markets around the globe. In more than 100 countries, these are the sample of the current customers and partners of EchoStar. EchoStar's consumer solutions include HughesNet, North America's number one high-speed satellite internet service. Over the last three decades, EchoStar's technology has significantly influenced the way consumers view, receive and manage TV programming.
Natupad ko na ang iyong kahilingan. Hanggang sa muli.
Microwave na ito, no?